Allah is bigger than 45. Seventh Surah Junction is bigger than 35. And as in your 55, we have to collect this derivation. And as you heard before, every group understood there are three surgical options to collect this disease. The two first option is that we call it a Walsh bagging procedure. The first one is the implantation technique by Professor Daly. And the second one is the remodeling. And the third one is retro operation. This is the three surgical options. And as we know that Walsh bagging have advantage that the patient does need long term and different plan and low risk of bone-related complications and good long-term result as the problems showed before. And this slide is not important because you learned that before. And my preference that I prefer to use to use the remodeling technique because the first few cases I did with the re-implantation, I found difficulty about the control reading and how to measure the valve and the graft. And when I tried another technique, I found it's more easy. And this professor Shepherd, I have good opportunity to visit that team in Germany and attend the meeting. He showed the technique that's more easy and straightforward to follow the technique. And as you know, that the physiology component of the aortic root remodeling is better than the re-implantation technique. So that's why I choose to the remodeling technique. And however, even the remodeling or implantation, as I mentioned, we have to collect every component of the aortic root, including the leaflet. We have to repair if the patient has aortic regurgitation or leaflet prolapse. If the leaflet severe infection, severe intoxication, or have a severe administration, this patient is not suitable for the false spelling technique. And we manage the sign up or observer by putting the valve, and we have to implant the chorion in ostium, the length of the line. In patient who have aortic aneurysm dilatation that's more than 25 mm, we have to fix the aneurysm dilatation by aneuroplasty technique. I will show you later how I do it. This is the technique. Let's start with the case. This is a 38-year-old lady presented to my hospital with severe back pain. The CT scan show the aortic root aneurysm. The depth is about 6.9 centimeters. And she also has a aortic dissection and aneurysm dilatation of the descending aorta. You can see in this picture a big aneurysm and descending as well. So the first step, I have to fix the aortic root before, because if I start with the descending aorta, so when we bypass, severe dilatation can cause the LV distension and the patient can deteriorate during the operation. This is the POT echo. You can see that the big sternum of Osawa, the glass and the condition have a small condition. And this is the color for sure related to severe degeneration of the sinus to the LVOT. And the cast still looks thin and no calculation. This is the regulation jet at the center. We measure the diameter, the elastic is not so big, it's about 23 millimeter at the center of our slide, about 6.9. That's big. This is a picture of this patient. You can see that the sinus is big and normal size of the aortic arch. So the calculation for this operation, I use standard, put the softball calculation at the aortic arch and use a two-step radar calculation. And after the cramp aorta, the cardioplegia used LED colostium with the castor oil solution. And put the weight, light sodium fluid weight, to drain the blood from LV. After cutting the aneurysm, we have to dissect to the resolving of the aortic valve. I prefer to use a sharp technique by using scissors to cut between the aortic wall and plain of the LA. You can see that. Normally, if the patient who did not have a severe inflammation, this plain can identify easily. And when we find the plain, we have to cut excite the sinus by using the tissue about 5 millimeters away from the aortic valve junction and prepare the coriosteum. This is the right coriosteum, you can see. And after we prepare the aorta and the leaflet, we turn the blood by taking from Professor Schaeffer. He used 24, 26, and 28 according to the body surface of the patient. Most of the care that you have 26 and 28, and we made a 3 equal of the plan. You can see that. And the anatomy is start at the area of the tongue to the lamen and continue upward to the commissure or side. If we found the incision still not enough, we can attain more the commissure. That's why I think it's more easier to do the anatomosis than the implantation technique. Sometimes when we do the implantation, we have to pull the commissure up. And if there are still kicking of the leaflet, we can face problem with bleeding from the anatomosis. But with this technique, we can see the graft and the anatomosis of the aortic wall, and we can collect before to go to another step. And when we do the neural sinus, we assess the valve. As the general was said before, we assess the geometric length of the cast that more than 90 millimeters and assess the effective height. This is the picture show how we call effective height. It's more than 9 meters, it should be okay for the valve. I don't have this caliber, but I made and something like this caliber to use. But now I'm going to have the original one and the last one. Maybe I can change to the original one. This is the ruler that I take for my son to do the caliber. Mm-hmm. And we can assess the competence of the valve. which many kind of technique. Saline test is one of the technique, but it's not so good, but it's okay. And this show how it's look like after we create the neosinus. You can see that the patient has the neo pelvic sinus, trigeminal sinus. And we usually cut above the cerebellar junction 1 to 2 centimeters. If we cut too high, it's difficult to access the pelvic floating hand. And we do the enteroplasty by, let me show you what I can. Using a CV4 clotting suture. Suture allow the soft tissue allow the vessel of the pelvic sinus.
We have a lot of leading complications, so
to do the anastomosis, I have to make sure that we put a good anastomosis. We have one most important the patient is that the dissection is effective each week. After I do the vertebral bypass at 3 p.m. in the early morning and start the antibiotic in the early morning today. And after the next day after operation, the patient still have fever, look like sepsis. I did a consultation to the general surgeon to do to examine the abdomen. But the patient had a diagnosis for ischemic myelin and severe sepsis progressed and the patient died from the septic shock. And you see that we have a lot of bleeding complications, so I try to make a good anastomosis before release the clamp. After operation, the AR become no or trivial AR. We have just one mild moderate, and most of the patients are in the first class 1 and 2. We don't have pre-operation, but we have one late 3 years after operation. The patient develop endocarditis and develop severe pneumonia. He cannot tolerate to do the re-operation and die from severe sepsis. In conclusion, I think the cross sparing is quite attractive because this technique provides good long-term result and good quality of life without any coagulant and eliminate the wild related